he's sporting a new haircut. Firstly, congratulations on your debut. How does it feel to be making your debut at Ellis Park against England?
Very excited. I mean, Ellis Park is a very special stadium in South African rugby, and it's even more special to me personally because that's where it all started. Obviously, I played rugby for the Lions in my junior rank, so Ellis Park was always the be-all, end-all, and yeah, very exciting.
Thank you. Before the next question, remember he's embargoed, okay? Just so you know. Thanks.
Spoo, you mentioned, I think, last year that you watched YouTube videos of Sean Johnson. Do you think that's prepared you much for the magnitude of Test rugby perhaps?
That wouldn't be enough for the magnitude of a Test rugby match. I think you'd need a little more attention on detail. The ball running won't be everything. There's a lot of things that go into a Test rugby game, especially for a winner. The backfield has to be managed, the high balls have to be taken, you know, the defense has to be marshaled. So certainly watching videos of Sean Johnson on YouTube won't cut that.
Coach mentioned that he thought you should have perhaps made your debut last season. Do you feel the same, or do you feel that's the right time?
No, I feel everything has its perfect timing, and the fact that it's happening now means the timing is perfect. I'm a more experienced player than I was last year, inevitably, because I've played more rugby, and I've learned some lessons along the way, especially in this particular season, especially now that I'm also playing on the right wing. So I think, yeah, the timing is perfect.
Considering how difficult it was and the previous coach, do you say that you perhaps think that this may be a bit blessing in disguise, that you are only playing under the new coach, the new era and everything, everyone is optimistic?
I don't know. I won't say it's a blessing in disguise or anything. I'm just happy that it's happening now, and I'm just happy that I've got a coach who gives me confidence, who gives me experience. So on game day, I've already been there mentally, you know, and I'm very prepared. Yeah.
Congrats. Have you spent a lot of time in the last 10 days with Apiwe and Billy and that sort of thing? And how's your relationship as the back three having to work very closely together?
I've spent basically all my time with them. You know, it's very important to understand your teammates. I think we put a lot of emphasis on analysing the opposition, but I think it's also important to analyse your own teammates so you can know how they play, how they like beating defenders, so you can know how to support them and things like that. And also to know like how they react to certain things, you know, and how you can bring out the best in them. So we've had to spend a lot of time together. I've loved every single second of it.
Spoo, how do you feel your game has evolved or improved over the last year? Rusty spoke on a bit of work under the high ball. What areas do you think that you've worked on and got better at?
I think for a young winger, the biggest challenge is to find yourself in the right positions at the right times. And I think I've done a lot of work on my positioning. Yeah, that's the biggest area that I've put a focus into, and Coach Rusty feels that I've grown immensely in that respect.
Sabu, and adding on to that, it also looks like you're looking for work more. Did you try and work on your work rate a lot?
This will bring me back to the point about experience. It's easy to look for work, but it's hard to know when to look. It takes us back to positioning. You might go off your wing to look for work, and a chance opens on the wing. You know, so I think it's more of a mental thing than anything. Just now that I know the right times and the right places to look for the work.
Okay, Sabu, every guy before his stage debut, the nerves on the Friday night before the game probably reach that boiling point. But what are you going to do to relax?
I'm not very nervous. I'm more excited than anything. I think I'm confident in the players that are surrounding me, and they bringing confidence out of me. We are very well prepared. There's a lot of attention to detail, so I don't feel any nerves as of yet, and I'm confident and excited.
Okay.
Spoo, just tell us a bit about your sort of early days in rugby and your memories of the Springboks, and maybe when you felt that you'd be able to play at this level one day.
sounds a bit surreal to say, but I feel like I've always wanted to, and I've never had the doubt in my mind. My mom's always been in my ear because she always saw from a young age how passionate I was about playing for the Springboks. So she never let me like have a single doubt in my mind. So it sort of, to me, feels like I've always known that I wanted to, and I've always known that I was gonna. And I think sport is a tough world, and you need that kind of faith if you wanna pull through to the highest level, and most importantly, stay at the highest level. A weird one. I think Beast probably. Beast has always been great for the Springboks, and you know, he shows the amount of passion and desire that is just undying, and I think I can learn a lot from that. But as well, positionally, Lwazi Mvovo, Odwa Ndungane have been great role models to me. And obviously, coming from the same union as them, I've learned a lot from them, which is, it's very lucky. I don't think many youngsters get to play with their childhood role models.
One or two more questions to English before we switch to Zulu.
Well,
can I please have one question at a time?
Thank you, sir.
One question, but nevertheless, have you spoken to any family members? When you guys get the call about the confirmation, you're going to be in the starting lineup?
We found out right before it's about to be announced to the media. And yeah, I haven't gotten any calls from family members yet because it's very new news, if I can use that term. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's not a dream come true yet. It's the beginning of a dream come true. I don't just want to play for the Springboks. I want to be excellent for the Springboks, and I want to do great in the jersey.
So we go with Ken, last one.
If you don't mind telling us, who are some of the special people who will be coming up to watch your big day on Saturday?
My family. I've got two younger siblings, my brother Sanele and my little sister Lindelo, and then my mom will also be coming. They play a big part in obviously my motivation, and I think motivation can be a very much underrated thing. Gives me a lot of confidence to know that they'll be watching from the stands. Abantu bengibhekele kubo ngisakhula, Odwa Ndungane, Lwazi Mvovo, Thenda Mtawarira, ama role models aqotho aqinile. So ukuthi ngizokhona ukudlala nomunye wabo kuyangijabulisa kakhulu. Ngikhule kakhulu, kuningi engikufundile, kuningi futhi ekusamele ngikufunde namanje, especially masikhuluma ngama-position specifics. Kunomsebenzi omningi okumele ayenzwe i-wing, a-diffuse i-kicking pressure from the opposition, a-apply i-kicking pressure, izinto ezikanjalo ebengingazazi kulo nyaka esibuya kuyo, engizaziyo kulo nyaka njalo. Ngicabanga ukuthi ngumdlali okhulile ongcono kunalo mdlali ebengiwona la last year. Yeah, kuvakala ngathi ngisekhaya vele, and ngiyithanda i-Ellis Park kakhulu, ngikhulele khona, and ngicabanga ukuthi kunenhlahla ukuthi ngikhone ukudlala i-test debut yami khona.
Okay.
kubaluleke kakhulu lo mdlalo lo I think umdlalo oqala wonke umuntu ubheke wena and kumele ukhombise ukuthi unawo amandla wokuyibamba leyo pressure leza nomdlalo we-test match rugby so kubaluleke kakhulu ngicabanga ukuthi ya ngizoba right ma-teammates amangisupporter and izinga le-confidence liphezulu No, I'm Sabluto.
Thank you very much, everyone. Remember.